You guys are looking for cheap, fast, and reliable Madden Ultimate Team coins? Look no further than my sponsor, MuttReserve.com. They're super great. They got fast 24/7 support. Make sure to check them out, and make sure you use code Poodle at checkout for an additional 15% off your order. What's going on, everybody? It's Poodle back with another Madden Ultimate Team video, guys. I'm going to be ranking the best autumn players to be picking. So remember, guys, there are two of them, right? There are the players that you get from the 80 overall base card from the solos. You upgrade all the way, like Fletcher Cox, to 92. And there's also the 91 Thanksgiving All-Stars that are going to be the ones that do end up getting upgraded based on their game day performances. So I'm going to start with the 80 to 92 overall players here real quick. So the ones you get free from the solos by putting food into them, I'm going to start with those four. I'm going to rank them out of four. And then I'm going to head on over to the All-Stars and who I think could get their Thanksgiving performances and actually be upgraded. So definitely a good video to be watching. Stay tuned to the end so you guys don't miss anything. I have a lot of input to put on these. But first, guys, for today's Poodle Squad shout-out, we got Torpy Bro Gaming. Shout-out to you, man, for being a part of the Poodle Squad. Thanks so much for showing support in each and every video. Appreciate you guys a lot. Thank you for showing support. Moving on from that, guys, if you need any coins to pick up any of these cards, you know, of course, it's going to be free, but the other ones, the All-Star Thanksgiving Day performers, you can use Leafs to pick up some more, so if you want some more, heading over to Mutt Reserve, you could probably buy the currency and everything directly on there, some coins, use code Poodle for 15% off your order down below, and take advantage of the Harvest discounts that we're going to be having. But let's get into this. So starting off with this list, guys, these lists, it wasn't exactly the easiest to make some of these lists because I did have to take a lot into account. But coming in at number four, guys, we have Fletcher, Scherf, Allen Robinson, Pat Pete. Coming in at number four, we got Allen Robinson. I don't even think he is four. I think he's worse than four, if that was even possible. If you're going to give me an 88 speed wide receiver, they better have all route running and catching above 90 base. No chems needed. They should just have a base. And that's not the case here with Allen Robinson. So sadly, Allen Robinson is going to be knocked down. Not going to be usable, guys. Do not get him. Even if you have a Bears theme team, I still don't think he's that great. But if you do, and you want to go ahead and get him, I guess I won't argue that as much. But guys, the catching is great. But he can't deep route run, and even if he could, he's too slow to probably do it effectively. Medium, you're going to need play fake to get it up, and again, even if he can, he can't do it effectively. And they run the meta defense, and you try drag slanting them, like or motion slanting them, he's not really that fast, so they could probably keep up, even if you do that. But coming at number three, guys, we have the next one, which is going to be Fletcher Cox. Now, Fletcher Cox is going to be a 92 overall defensive tackle. I contemplated putting him at two, but the thing is, a lot of people don't use defensive tackles. They'll use two outside linebackers on the outside. They'll put some ends in the middle. They'll just fast the defensive tackles. But 75 speed, 81 excel, 89 strength, 92 tackle, 92 play rec, 89 blocks, 93 power move, and 77 finesse move. It's actually really good. Power from Kemp, he will have an above 90 block shed. You can get his power move up there pretty high, above 95. And his strength's going to be above 90. And his speed and acceleration is decent enough to really get the job done. Now, in my opinion, I think he's really, really good. It's just a matter of, like, how long you use him for. Do you use defensive tackles? Coming in at number two, we're going to have Brandon Scherf. Now, I think what Brandon Scherf is, a 92 right guard, powered 93, you can have for a while, right? Like, you can just slot him in there and just rock with him. You won't notice him. You don't have to actually, you know, use him. Just have him in there, and he'll block for you. He has all above 90 pass blocking with Kems, and then all above 90 run blocking with Kems as well. He's going to be just a great, solid right guard to fill in, and you probably won't notice much of a big difference between him and other right guards. I think he's super, super solid, and of course, he's a guard, so, like, no one, you don't like paying for guards, right? Like, I'll pay for John Randall and then get a free right guard versus pay for a right guard and then have a free offensive tackle. You know what I mean? But they're two positions you both don't like paying for. But right guard, probably a little bit less. Next, guys, for the final one, we got Pat P coming number one. Pat P far and away is the best one here. Powered up and chemmed up, guys. He'll have a 92 speed. Insanely fast. He'll have, I think his man can get up to a 98, 99, potentially. His zone can get up to about a 96, 97. His press can get up to like a 92, 93. And his play rec can get up to a 92, 93 as well. So he's going to be super fast, all threshold corner, and his man may be able to get to a 99. If that's the case, he will be a super solid meta cornerback. Now, guys, let's get into the final rankings of the Thanksgiving Day performers. Let's go over to them and check them out. Six, guys, the worst one on Thanksgiving Day players is going to be Jalen Smith. Now, guys, the thing with Jalen Smith is going to be that he's a linebacker. And sadly, this year, Madden has allowed us to phase linebackers out of the equation. Maybe it's us being losers and not using them. But overall, guys, linebackers aren't used anymore as much because you can just put a safety there. Here's the thing. Safeties will be faster than Jalen Smith. They will play better coverage than Jalen Smith. And they will be just about as hard hitting as Jalen Smith and have better block shed. Now, the block shed on Jalen Smith is really what kills this card. Now, if they had given Jalen Smith, let's say, 88 block shed, which I understand is a pass coverage linebacker. If he had 88 block shed and that was able to get to 90 with the hip power, with the zone, with the speed, I would say go for it. He could stop the run, play the pass, and it'd be fast enough to catch and do everything else. But the issue is here, even if he does get it, right? So they're versing the Washington football team. They do run a lot. I could see him getting the tackles. I don't know if he'll get the sack. I could see him getting the 92, but even if he gets all of his upgrades, guys, he's not usable. You know, there's going to be a better safety there. So that's kind of the issue with him. Moving on, guys, to the next one. Who's actually, this guy's decent. I just don't know if I'd do it. Desmond Trufant. Now, he's only played in four total games. And the thing with Desmond Trufant, he has gotten the tackles the last two games, three plus tackles. So I can see him getting the 92, which is why he's at least number five. They're versing the Houston Texans. Now, again, could they throw an interception? Possible. They do pass a decent amount. Their running game hasn't really been hitting. Now, interception, guys, interception's luck. That's the only reason I don't like cornerbacks. Is, like I said in my other video, it's luck. You know, yes, it's skill to be in the position to be, you know, to intercept, but if the quarterback doesn't throw to you all game, it doesn't matter how good you are, you're not going to interception. If they run a lot that game, you're not getting interception. If Watson's on all cylinders and doesn't throw any bad throws, like, that doesn't throw right to you, you're not getting interception. So, it's going to be tough to really guarantee that. So, at number five, if he gets his upgrade, let's say even to 93, I predict a 92, though. At a 92, guys, he'll still be an all-threshold corner with a 91 speed. It's average. He could potentially get 92 with a power-up. So he's going to be a good cornerback. I just don't think he'll be great, but he won't be too far behind Pat P, which is why he's still at least number five. Coming in next, guys, we have Deshaun Watson. Now, Deshaun Watson's number four. Now, I would have put him higher if his stats and his archetype are better, but it's improviser, it's not field general. And, of course, his stats are pretty good, though, guys. He's going to be one of the best quarterbacks in the game, and I actually do think his odds of hitting this are pretty high. The thing with Watson is that he does usually play in shootouts typically, so I can see him getting it. Now, to show you guys the stats last game. So, yesterday, he had a really bad game yesterday. He had one touchdown, 163 passing yards, right? That was a bad game, though. Against Jacksonville, he had two total touchdowns, 281. Against Green Bay, he had two total touchdowns, 309. Against Tennessee, let's see, he had 335, four touchdowns. Against Jacksonville, again, he had three touchdowns, 359. So, I think the passing yards is almost a lock. I think he'll hit it in a game against the Detroit Lions. I think he'll hit the passing yards, right? So I think he'll get a 92 guaranteed. Now, the touchdown is going to be the hard part. I don't know if he'll go for four, but I think I have a good feeling he'll either hit both of them. And if he hits both of them, guys, he'll have an 89 speed powered up. He'll have like a 94 throw power. So you can get that up to a 99 throw power with an 89 speed with a above 90 short, above 90 medium, and above 90 deep. Now, the way you're going to hit this, if he gets all of them, he'll have the short and medium base. And then, of course, his deep accuracy will get up, will go deep. And then he is thrown under pressure. So he's going to be one of the best quarterbacks in the game, regardless of his archetype. So I really do like him. But, of course, it's an abilities game, right? So you got to play to the ability. So if he can't get certain abilities or he struggles with some things, it's going to hurt him more than others. But again, I think Watson's a really good option. Safe, should definitely get something. Moving on, guys. Kendall Fuller coming to number three. Kendall Fuller on Thanksgiving Day needs one pass defended, one interception. I feel like this is super, super easy. It's a safe one, right? So against the Cowboys, all he's going to need is one pass defended to get to that 92. And I think he doesn't even need all that, guys. All he needs is the 92. Because at 92, powered up, he's already going to have a 94 man. Which means he will get to 99 man coverage. Now, for the zone coverage, guys, for him to get 99 zone, he's going to quite literally need to get all. I don't even think he can. He's going to get like a 98. He's going to need to get to 92 powered up and everything to get to 98. So I just care about the speed at this point. If he gets an interception, that's cool because he will get to like a 94 speed, which will make him the fastest safety, man, zone, safety, everything in the game, which will beat McCourty and those guys. So I do think Kendall Fuller is a really, really, really good option if you guys get it. He will be a meta-style free safety, of course. We don't care about hit power as much anymore. He'll be really good. Next on the list is a guy that I think quite literally is already the best tight end in the game, is Eric Ebron. He has the same speed as Waller, chemmed up with play fake and power. Well, he can't be powered up, but chemmed up, I think they will drop power for him, but chemmed up, he will have the same route running threshold and everything. So he's just as good as Waller. Guys, four receptions for Ebron. Now, the thing is with them, they have a really big passing tree, so they pass a lot, but they also have a lot of guys. So he had six targets last game. So if he catches a few more of those, he gets that. The game before that, so he had two receptions last game, three receptions the game before that. He had four receptions the game before that, six receptions, two receptions, five receptions. So I think there's a decent chance he hits it. Now, 70 receiving yards is going to be the hard part, guys. I don't even know if he's cleared that once this season, if he's even cleared that at all. Yeah, it does not look like he's cleared that even once. So it's going to be super hard for him to actually go ahead and get that. But he's going to, of course, try. So for me personally, I believe that it's going to be tough for him to get the second one. So what he's going to need here is just the one. Now, if he gets just the one, that makes him the best tight end because he is going to have a 88 speed base. And, of course, they give him a power even better. But he gets the 88 speed. His catching will be all above 90. His route running will be all above 90. So all that's going to matter here is the 88 speed. So he's going to be the fastest tight end that has route running threshold. So he's going to be the best tight end in the game. And if they throw him a power-up, guys, even better. And if he does happen to get both, which I think is highly unlikely, I really don't think against the Ravens he's going to get all that. They have really good line. They have really good, just a really good defense in general. But if they do, if he does get all that, guys, he's going to be an extreme meta tight end, but I don't think he will. And now for the final guy, on this list, which is my favorite of the bunch, is Marquise Brown. Now, here's the thing. Marquise Brown has so much potential. Off the rip, Marquise Brown is going to be one of the best receivers in the game, right? He can get, with play fake, he'll get the play fake, he'll get short and medium, and his catching will be slightly below, and he'll have a 93 speed. Here's the thing about Marquise Brown. He has so much upside, right? 60 receiving yards and one touchdown. That's just one play for him, right? So if it was, like, let's say, Golden Tate or, like, you know, like a Julian Edelman or Allen Robinson, I'd say, okay, so he's going to need for 60 receiving yards and a touchdown, probably, like, 5 to 6 receptions, probably, a few good catches because they're possession receivers. Marquise Brown just needs one play. That's it. He's that fast. They typically use him deep. Now, all season, he's had touchdowns, but he's only had one game, I believe, or two games. He's had two games, maybe three. Let's see. He's had three games above 60 yards. So, all it takes is one blown coverage. They are versing the Steelers, which means they'll probably be a pretty, decently high-scoring game. So, one big play. That's all it takes. One big play, and you have a 93 overall, guys. If he gets a 93 overall, and that's how I see it, too. If he gets a 60-plus yards, he probably scored as well. So, he's going to have a 93 overall, which will leave him with a 95 speed, above 90 catching, everything all above 90 catching, just about. Maybe catching traffic might be one short. He'll have them short, medium, and deep route running threshold with a 95 speed. He will be the best wide receiver in Madden 21. So that's why he has that kind of potential, right? Because all the other players, Eric Ebron will be the best tight end, which is just a tight end. Fuller will be a great, maybe best free safety. Watson will be close to one of the best quarterbacks. But Marquise Brown will be the fastest player in Madden while also being the best wide receiver. It's a no-brainer. That's where we want to go. Guys, that is about it for the video. Hope you guys did enjoy. If you guys need any more advice, comment down below in the comment section. If you guys need coins to pick up any of these players that you want more than just one, go down below. Go to muttreserve.com. Use code Poodle 15% off. Take advantage of the Thanksgiving promo codes and all that other stuff, harvest stuff. And that's about it, guys. Thank you so much for watching. If you want to shout out in the Poodle Squad, like the video, comment down below Poodle Squad, and that's about it. Turn the noti bell. I'm out. See you guys later. Peace.